Most scientific reports on climate look at changes that have occurred since the pre-industrial era, or since record-keeping began. But even looking back at the past decade, it's clear that our world today is very different from the world of 2010. Much of the public discussion around climate change has focused on how much the Earth will warm over the coming century. But climate change is not limited just to temperature. How precipitation, both rain and snow, changes will also have an impact on the global population. The studies related to precipitation and their findings are significant not just because of flood risk. From drinking water to agriculture and hydroelectric power, a predictable supply of water is vital to practically all forms of human activity. Recent studies found that, due to the human activities from the pre-industrial era, the Earth's average surface temperature is getting increased day by day. With higher temperatures comes greater evaporation and surface drying, potentially contributing to the intensity and duration of drought. However, as the air warms, its water-holding capacity increases, particularly over the oceans. According to the Clausius-Clapeyron equation, the air can generally hold around 7% more moisture for every 1 degree Celsius of temperature rise. As such, a world that is around 4 degrees Celsius warmer than the pre-industrial era would have around 28% more water vapor in the atmosphere. But this increased moisture will not fall evenly across the planet. Some areas will see increased precipitation, while other areas are expected to see less due to shifting weather patterns and other factors. Extreme rains or cloudburst, along with the flooding, landslides, and other devastation they cause, are some of the deadliest weather events worldwide. Let's analyze the regular floods that has been witnessing by the South Indian state of Kerala for the past few years. It all started with the century's biggest floods in 2018, and since then every year, Kerala has seen heavy rains and flash floods. In 2018, nearly 500 people were killed in Kerala when it was ravaged by the worst floods to hit the state in almost a century. Changes in Kerala's climate received more attention during recent times, as evident from back-to-back drought conditions during 2015 and 2016. In 2017, Kerala was hit by the cyclonic storm, Aki, and catastrophic flood and landslide episodes followed during 2018, 2019, 2020, and 2021. Some experts consider the cloudburst phenomenon as one of the reasons for frequent floods. Along with that, illegal stone quarrying activity and deforestation for new constructions made frequent happening of landslides. Cloudburst is basically a rainstorm and occurs in high-altitude areas due to the formation of a low-pressure area on the top of a mountain. The low-pressure zone attracts clouds to the top of the mountain with great force. When they hit the peak, the moisture content is released in the form of rain. Due to the presence of the Western Ghats, Kerala is considered a cloudburst-prone zone. Quarrying and deforestation activities in the Western Ghats lead to an increase in the flow of rainwater towards the sea by flooding cities and villages. Unnecessarily constructed dams and improper water management lead to worsening the situation. According to the study by Western Ghats Ecology Expert Panel, which was constituted by the Government of India under eminent ecologist Madhav Gajal, several regions in Kerala were classified as ecologically sensitive zones where floods and landslides have been common. The report, based on data from the ground and satellite imagery, the Gajal panel submitted its report in September 2011. The panel suggested strict restrictions on mining, timber felling, quarrying, and on the use of land for non-forest purposes. However, there was opposition from almost all political parties in Kerala against the report, and it has never been implemented. The Union Environment Ministry later appointed another panel, headed by eminent space scientist K. Kasturirangan, to examine the Gajal Committee report in a holistic and multidisciplinary manner. The Kasturirangan Committee submitted its report in 2013 but watered down the recommendations of the Gajal panel. The Kasturirangan panel suggested that only a third of the Western Ghats need to be identified as ecologically sensitive. The future multimodel created by climate scientists show large increases in precipitation near the equator, particularly in the Pacific Ocean. They also show more precipitation in the Arctic and Antarctic, where cold temperatures currently limit how much water vapor the air can hold. Kerala is in the southern part of India and near to the equator. So in the future also, Kerala and other equatorial places in the world will experience increased precipitation levels and heavy rainfall. But we can decrease the loss going to happen during these extreme climate events. Just act environmentally.
Thank you.